Hello and welcome. This is Alauddin Ahmed and today we will going to discuss on joint venture accounts. A joint venture is a combination of two or more persons into a single activity. It is a form of partnership which is limited to a specific venture. It may seem to be exactly the same as partnership, with the exception that is one of a business that is to be terminated. Since the business is to be concluded after completion of the venture, a firm name is not generally used. There are many reasons for a joint venture. A joint venture is undertaken when different persons have mutual advantages in tackling a particular business venture together. For example, an individual may be in a particular advantageous position to buy goods exceptionally cheap but lacks capital. An associate might agree to provide the capital to finance the whole project. When the respective advantages of the parties are pulled together, the persons can undertake a joint venture for mutual profit. There are some features of a joint venture. At first, it is a specific partnership, and it does not entail a continuing partnership since termination is certain. So, the business is dissolved after the venture is terminated, as it is a business which is not continuing. Many accounting concepts are not applicable, such as the going concern concept. Ascertainment of income is relatively simple. All the assets are ultimately received in cash and all liabilities are paid in cash. And finally, it does not use a firm name generally. So, what are the differences between partnership and joint venture? In partnership business, it is a going concern. But joint venture business is a terminable venture. Partnership always has a name, but a joint venture does not bear a name. Persons carrying on a business are called partners in partnership, but persons carrying on business are called co-ventures on a joint venture business. Profits are ascertained at regular intervals in a partnership business, but the profits are ascertained for each venture separately in joint venture business. Joint venture accounts can be kept in the manner that will suit the co-ventures in a particular case. There are two important methods to continue the joint venture accounts. The first method is used when a separate set of books is kept for a joint venture, and the second method will use when no separate set of books is kept for the joint venture. When the size of the venture is larger and the duration of the ventures is protracted, then a complete separate set of books of account may be maintained under the double entry system for recording all joint venture transactions. Under this system, that is, when a separate set of books is kept, there are some accounts are commonly maintained in the ledger. The first one is joint bank account. For better financial control, a joint bank account is opened especially for the venture. The co-ventures operate this account jointly. This account is just like a cash book. All cash deposited into the bank is debited and all withdrawals are credited. Generally, capital contribution of the ventures and sale proceeds are deposited in this account. Similarly, all major payments are made from this account. It is finally closed by payment to the co-ventures. And another account is the co-venture accounts. This account records the transactions between the venture and the co-ventures. Since these are the capital accounts of the co-ventures, they are credited for what they contributed to the venture and debited for any withdrawals from the venture. The co-venture's contribution towards the joint venture by way of cash, goods or services is credited to these accounts. Goods and sale proceeds taken over by co-ventures are debited on these accounts. The profit or loss on venture is credited or debited respectively in these accounts and ultimately closed off by cash payment from the joint bank balance. And another account is joint venture account. It is in the nature of a trading and profit and loss account, and it is prepared to ascertain the profit or loss on joint venture. Goods purchased, goods supplied by the co-ventures, expenses incurred, etc. are debited to this account, and sale proceeds, unsold stock and the like are credited to it. The final balance represents profit or loss on the venture, which is transferred to the co-ventures account in the profit sharing ratio. It is interesting to note that no separate accounts for purchases, sales and expenses are maintained. All these are directly entered in the joint venture account. Among these three accounts, joint venture account is closed first of all, transferring the profit or loss to the co-ventures accounts. Thereafter, joint bank account and co-ventures accounts are closed simultaneously, ensuring that the resultant claim of the ventures are equal to the available joint bank balance. When the size of the venture is small and co-ventures are residing at distant places, each co-venture may record joint venture transaction in his own books of account without inaugurating a complete set of double entry books for the venture. In such a case, that is when no separate set of books is kept, two variations are possible. The first one is when each co-ventures maintain a complete record of all the joint venture transaction, and the second one is when each co-venture maintains a record of his own transaction only. When each co-ventures maintain a complete record of all the joint venture transaction, each co-venture will record in his own books of account all transaction relating to the joint venture. Each co-venture will open in his ledger two accounts. The first one is joint venture account, which is a nominal account and may be treated as a special profit and loss account, which discloses profit or loss on venture. It is prepared in the same manner as illustrated previously. One's own share of profit or loss is transferred to the profit and loss account, whereas the co-venture's share of profit is transferred to their respective personal accounts. And another account is personal accounts of co-ventures, which are credited with cash, goods and services supplied by the co-ventures and debited with goods, sales, proceeds taken over, remittance and the like. Share of profit or loss is credited or debited respectively to these accounts. The balances of these accounts are shown in the balance sheet. Under this system, each co-venture will send from time to time a statement of the transactions entered into by him to his co-venture, who will accordingly make appropriate entries in his own book of account. And when each co-venture maintains a record of his own transaction, each co-venture records in his books of account those transactions with which he is concerned. He does not record any transactions of his co-ventures. In this method, each co-venture opens two accounts. joint venture with other co-venture accounts and memorandum joint venture account. Joint venture with other co-venture account is in the nature of a personal account. Each co-venture debits this account with all the payments and supplies made by him on behalf of the joint venture, such as purchase, expenses and the like, and credit it with all the payments received by him on behalf of the venture. This account is a part of the double entry system of the venture concerned. It should be remembered in the context that joint venture with other co-venture account is not a nominal account and does not disclose any profit or loss. The other account is memorandum joint venture account. As soon as the venture is completed, each party submits a copy of his account to others. With the help of this information, each co-venture prepares a memorandum joint venture account which shows profit or loss on venture. This account simply summarizes the expenses and incomes of all parties in respect of the joint venture for the purpose of ascertaining profit on venture. Since it is a memorandum account, it does not form a part of the double entry system. Let's talk about the valuation of unsold stock. Where accounts are to be prepared before the completion of the venture, stock in hand at the balancing date must be valued. The value of the unsold stock is credited to the joint venture account and debited to the stock on joint venture account. In the next period, it should be brought down in the debit side of the joint venture account. The unsold stock should be valued by the principle of cost price or market price, whichever is lower. The cost price should include cost of unsold goods and proportionate non-recurring expenses such as freight, insurance, carriage inward and the like, but not selling or distribution cost. Before the completion of the venture, if an interim settlement is desired and there is some unsold stock lying in the hands of either or both the parties, then it may be treated in some manner. At first method, there are some steps. The first step is credit memorandum joint venture account with unsold stock and bring it down on the debit side as balance in the next period. The next step to divide the unsold stock between the co-ventures in the profit sharing ratio. And the final step is each co-venture in his books will bring down his share of stock separately without merging with other dues. In the second method, the first step to credit memorandum joint venture account with unsold stock and bring it down on the debit as balance in the next period, and don't divide the unsold stock between the co-ventures. And the next step, each co-venture in his own books will bring down the amount of unsold stock that he has on hand. And that's all for now. Thank you.